Okay, children. So here, the continuation of 10th part. So now, let us discuss exercise problems. So in the 14.1, the first exercise, the second problem I am going to explain. See, they are given here one data, means group data. Daily wages in group is number of workers, means 200 to 250 rupees, 12 members they are getting. Like they given one table and they are asking find mean by appropriate method. So why they are asking appropriate method? So here appropriate method means to find out mean, we have three methods. In the three methods, which method is very suitable to find out this, that they are asking. So that means appropriate. So which is very suitable to this, then that method we have to take. So how can you find out then which method is suitable for this? Already I told you, if any problem if they will ask find mean, just we have to go through the step deviation method. Already I told you. But so here, see children, so generally we have to find out by using step deviation method only. See, when the given data in the small values, see here 200 to 250, 250 to 300, big values are there. In the frequency also 12, 14, 8, 6, 10, so little bit big values are there. So that's why here, when the given problem in big values, just you go through the step deviation method. Then otherwise you have the first problem in this. So 2, 3, 1, like the given fractions. So if a small values they will give, then just you go through the direct method. Because the multiplication you will get very easy. Then here if you use direct method, then more big values, means I mean in the points, decimal values also you will get. So when we are getting decimal values, while multiplying you will get confused. So that's why, so use step deviation method only. So otherwise if they want us like appropriate method, if they give particular method name, then go through that. So what here appropriate they are asking, then I am explaining by using step deviation method, which means third method. Solution. And first we have to prepare and we have to make table for the step deviation method. Then the first one is I am taking as class intervals. Then the second one I am taking as F, nothing but frequency. Right. Right. What is class intervals? 200 to 250. Next, 250 to 300. 300 to 350. 350 to 400. Then 400 to 450. Children, then frequency 12, 14, then 8, 6, 10. The first what we have to do, we have to find out mid values, nothing but class marks. So this we can denote by X, class marks. Then class marks, how you will find out? You know very well. The average of this one, 200 plus 250, total 450. 450 by 2. So 450 by 2. 2 twos are. Here 1, it will become 10. Then 2 fives are. So 225 we are getting here. Then again, this 250, 300, 0, 5, here 550. So 550 by 2. 2 2s are 4. 1 carry means it will become 15. 2 7s are 14. 2 5s are 2. 75. Then how much we are getting difference here? 225, 275. 50 we are getting difference. 275 minus 225. And 0, 5, 0 means 50. So for every number, if you add 50, 50, you will get that. Then if you add 50, then 5, how much you will get here? 12, then 325. Then 325 plus 50, 375. 375 plus 50, 425. So these are the mid values. Then we should find out the D values. You know very well how to find out D. D is nothing but X minus A. Then what is A? We have to assume one value from the mid values. So how we are assuming that in the frequency, what is the biggest value? 14. From the 14, the straight, bigger the straight, mid value is take as A. Now the assumed mean value is 275. So the assumed value, if it is, then this value subtract from these all. 225 minus 275 minus 50. 325 minus 275 minus 275 0. 325 minus 275 50. Then 375 minus 275. Then you can subtract here. So here, what is 375 minus 275 0 0. How much we will get? 100 we should get. Then here 425, 375, sorry 275. So 425 minus 275. Then 0, 12 means 5. Here 3 minus 2, 1. So 150. This is value of D. Then U. Very carefully, children. So here U is nothing but X minus A by C. So here C, the C value, the difference between these two. 250 minus 200, so 50. This is class interval, it's class size. So here, so we can use this formula. Then otherwise, I told you one condition. So say where we are getting 0, in the D, the straight value, take 0, then above the 0, take minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, like below the 0, 1, 2, 3. Then after, find out F, U. Why? In the formula, A plus sigma F U by N into C. So first you find out F U. So F U, 12 into minus 1, minus 12. 14 into 0, 0. 8 into 1, 8. 6 2s are 12. Then 10 3s are 30. Then again you find out sigma F U. Then first you add these all, then subtract minus. So here, minus 12 plus 12, anyway, cancel. 30 plus 8, 38. Then here n is equal to, right, how much? 12 plus 14, 26. 26, 8, 34. 34 plus 4, 6, 40. 40 plus 10, 15. Right. So now find out mean. Mean x bar is equal to a plus sigma fu by n into c. Then a value 275 plus sigma fu value 38 by n value 50 and class size also 50. So 50 cancel. Then 275 plus 38. Then 275 plus 38. So 38 plus 3. 11. 313. So 313 is mean. So this is answer 313. Children, then how to find out the mean by using step deviation method. So this is very carefully, children. Next one more problem we will discuss in the next video.